Students, so welcome. So from today onwards we are going to start with the semester 4th of botany, paper 2nd, that is a plant biotechnology, the credit one, that is a plant biotechnology and its introduction. So this is the first topic of it. So basically when we say the introduction of this biotechnology, so biotechnology, it can be viewed as a group of useful enabling technologies. It has wide and diverse applications in industry, commerce and environment. So biotechnology has its roots in the distant past, so it has a large, highly profitable modern industrial outlets of a great value of to the society. Example, we can say food industry, pharmaceuticals, then biofertilizers, fermented products and tissue cultures, in agriculture as well as in the biofuel, etc. So the term we can say, what is biotechnology? So the term biotechnology was first suggested in 1990 by the Karl Ikri, which was a Hungarian engineers. So in 1940, fermented products penicillin was discovered in England, and we can say industrially produced in USA. So traditional biotechnology has been used for thousands of years to improve the food and health care products. So today modern biotechnology enables us to develop, we can say, improve products more safely and more rapidly than even before it was. So when we say biotechnology, it is an applied biology. So it includes classical techniques such as fermentation and food production. For the food production, basic thing, it is a example, that is, we can say single cell protein. So this classical biology aspects were vastly improved by the biotechnology. So we can say biotechnology, it is a new discipline which produces as a result of a marriage between the biological science and the technology one. Okay, so according to the definition, which was suggested by Organizations for Economic Cooperation and Development, that was the application of scientific and engineering principles to the processing of materials by biological agents to provide goods and services to the mankind one. Okay, and the next, that was definition, that was according to the International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, the application of biochemistry, biology, microbiology and chemical engineering to industrial processed products and on environment. What are the scopes of and importance of the biotechnology? The first thing, that is according to medicines, or we can say medical biotechnology. So DNA probes are used in this for the disease diagnosis, like various, for example, we say sleeping sickness, malaria, Kala Azar. So these DNA probes are produced by genetically engineered microbes. Okay, then recombinant vaccines are produced by genetically engineered microbes. So such vaccines are clear safer against human hepatitis B viruses than E. coli vaccines for pigs, rabies viruses, etc. So again, so genetically engineered bacteria are developed, yielding valuable drugs like human insulin, human interferons, humans and bovines growth hormones, etc. So again, it is also used in the gene therapy, is developed to cure genetic diseases. Then biotechnology, it also has a scope in confirmation of criminal cases also, and we can say parents by using autoantibody fingerprinting from even blood and semen strains, hair roots, etc. So by hybridoma technology, that is a hybridoma, it is a hybrid cell obtained from by a fusing a B lymphocyte using with usually a tumor cell of antibody forming a system, or we can say B lymphocyte having ability to produce antibodies which are used for disease, hepatitis B and other viral diseases, we can say cancer, etc. So these are the some importance of biotechnology in medicines. Then industrial biotechnology or the biotechnology in industry. So fermentation, which is a traditional system, again we can say fermentation of substrate is brought about by bacteria, fungi and yeast to produce ethanol, lactic acid, citric acid, glycerin, glyconic acid, acetone, etc. So next, that is antibodies are produced with the help of bacteria, fungi and actinomycetes. Example, that is a penicillin, antibiotics, this is a penicillin, streptomycin. Okay, then next, enzymes are produced from fungi and bacteria. So they are used in detergent, textiles, leather, dairy and medicines also. Example, we can say amylase, protease, lipase. Okay, then next, that is single cell protein. A biomass is produced from the bacteria, yeast, fungi, algae, etc. Microbial fermentation of biomass is carried out to produce biofuel also. So example of biofuel, biogas from cow dung and human waste, ethanol from the molasses also. So these are the some importance of industrial biotechnology. Now the next, that is environmental biotechnology, or we can say biotechnology in environmental management. So efficient strains of microbes are developed for effective sewage treatment, or we can say deoxidizations of human excreta, etc. A new strains of Pseudomonas pudita, that is a bacterium, it is developed for degradations of petroleum and management of oil spills. So genetically engineered microbes are developed for detoxification of wastage and industrial influents. So environmental friendly methods are developed, example biocontrol of pest and diseases, they help to reduce the pollutions also. So this is one of the important of environmental biotechnology. Now the next very important, that is the agriculture biotechnology. So extensive work is now conducted in nitrogen fixation and transfer of nitrogen fixation genes, that is the NIF genes we can see. So then meristem culture or the tissue culture has high rates of multiplications, and thus in low cost many plants can be obtained. Then azo-rhizo fertilizers, then mycorrhizia, then phosphosolubilizer, then azolla, etc. are used as a biofertilizers for their mass production. Again, biopesticides is also one of the important one. Then revolutionary development in crop productions is achieved through gene transfer, or we can say genetic engineering for insect resistance, that is the BT cotton one. So protection against viruses, then herbicides, resistance, storage, protein improvement, etc. So these are some of the importance of agriculture biotechnology. Now we can say, it has a vast uses of biotechnology, but it is linked to each other only. Then only we can say biotechnology is a fulfilled one. So interdisciplinary nature of biotechnology. So it is an applied biology, we can say biotechnology, it is an applied applied biology. So it has a modern technology, but it is also an old as hills one. Okay, so much of interest is now being created in this area because of its potential in production processes. Some of the old and new with aid of production engineering and the electronics and new technologies is also been used. So these are the basic or the traditional subjects are also traditional methods are also been used with the involvement of the new technologies, as we can say microbiology, biochemistry, then chemical engineering, computer science has been used, bioinformatics has been used, molecular biology, fermentation. So these are the new technology, or we can say advanced technology has been used. So there are many interdisciplinary natures for the production of new products for the mankind only. Okay. Now what are the current status of biotechnology in India? As we all know, we are suffering now, we are suffering for the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay. Now for last 2 years, we are suffering this. So there are a number of vaccines has been provided, been created from all throughout the world. So out of this, there are two important vaccines have been produced by India. That is what Covaxin and the Covishield. So Covaxin, which is an Indian company in Hyderabad, we can say Bharat Biotech. Okay, with the Indian Councils of Medicine Research, it is prepared. Again, the Covishield, that is the Serum Institute of India, which is producing in Pune, okay, in Maharashtra ones. As well as we can say, biotechnology has helped India to produce many, we can say, sterilization techniques also there, or we call precautions, for that is PP kits have been, it has given idea to prepare it. Okay, so again, we can say the another, that is a traditional method, you can say the component annual growth rate of biotechnology in India is about 20%. So biotechnology is one of the emerging field that can add new and better applications in wide range of sectors like healthcare, service sectors, agriculture and processing in India. So in India, India is ranked 12th in the world in biotechnology and 3rd in the Asia specifics. So in biopharma accounts for the majority of the market shares in India. So out of the 10 biotechnology companies in India, 7 companies have expertise in biopharmaceuticals and 3 specialized in the agriculture biotechnology ones. So India has many government and autonomous institutes in biotech producing, we can say providing facilities for research and development and for the R&D purpose only. So about we can say 800 biotech companies are present in India today. So biopharma sector is contributing about 62% of the total revenue, followed by the bio services sectors, okay, that is 18%, then bio services, that is 15%, then biological industry, that is 4%, and bioinformatics, that is only 1% one. So the major shareholders are the, we can say, major revenue collected from the biopharmaceutical, that is 62%. Okay, so the government of India is trying to project India as a global hub for biotech research and businesses excellences with the help of DBT. Various agencies are there. Small Industry Development Bank of India is providing lot of funds to the micro, small and medium enterprises also. So government initiatives are most favorable for the growth of biotech industries. Okay, in future, biotech is the most vital and updated area for the Indian growth, I think so. And most of the trusted areas of biotechs are the agriculture, then bio nanotechnology, biocatalyst, genetic engineering, microalgae, biofuel, seed industry, biofertilizers, then stem cell research. Again, we can say there are various leading biotech companies in India of today, that is Bharat Biotech is there, then Dr. Reddy is there, then Serum is also there, then Ranbax is there, Biocon industry is there. Okay, there are various industries are working now, as well as there are government also there, 6 to 7 different agencies which are ready to finance this, that is a DBT, DST, UGC, ICR, then Biotech Industry Research Assistant Council is there, okay, then ICMR is there. So hence today we can say India is a biotech growth catalyst. Okay, so thank you.